A startup company by the name of Ubiquiti6 have developed an app that lets you scan real-world objects into a 3D model. They reached out to us for a sponsorship and asked to try out their app, DisplayLand. Now at first I was a little bit skeptical about it. 3D scanning is not something new, but it is a very expensive process as you need dedicated hardware for it. Now of course, DisplayLand is not gonna give you similar results, but it's definitely one of the best mobile apps that I've ever seen, and the great thing about it is that it's completely free. There's no paid premium wall behind it, there aren't even ads, it's just completely free, which is why you should definitely try it out. Now being just an app on your phone, the results are actually quite good. Although I have to mention that it takes some practice. My first scan of the office here was a complete disaster, but as we practiced and actually read their help guides, things got better. And by the way guys, let me know in the comments down below if you have ever created your own 3D model or if you're planning to start with 3D and which program that you might prefer. I'm always curious to know such things about you. But anyways, here are a few tips to get better scans using DisplayLand. First of all, make sure that there's enough texture, both on the ground and in your background. More texture means more information that the app can use to make the model better. Next, try to avoid hard lighting and reflections. Now, things like windows don't always work that well. It's just like with windows. Pun intended. Now, while scanning, first take distance and loop around an object 2 or 3 times. If you're scanning a room, walk around 2 or 3 times. And it's very important that you walk and not just pan with the camera. Take low, mid, and high perspectives as well. Then you can go closer to the object and do the same thing again. Walk around it for 2 or 3 times while taking a low, mid, and high perspective. There's an indicator in the app that tells you how much information you've given it. The more, the better, of course. The iOS version of the app also displays small dots, which helps to understand better how well the scanning goes and where you might need to capture more information from. Now it's expected that this update also comes to Android very soon, and speaking about devices, the app is unfortunately only officially supported by a handful of Android devices. But officially supported just means that the company has QA'd the device. I've got a OnePlus 7, which is not officially supported, and it actually does work. So do try it out and see how it goes on your phone. The one harsh requirement for Android devices is that they support Google's AR core. Alright, we've scanned a model, what can we do with it now? Well, actually a lot. For starters, DisplayLand is also a social media platform. You can publish your scan so that other people can explore it. Or you can explore other people's work and get some inspiration. You can also create different notes and add a description to it. And you know, this could actually be very interesting to make a pre-production for an upcoming shoot. You know, you scan a location and afterwards you save your camera frames or angles in that scan. Kind of like a storyboard, but then in 3D. Other people within your crew could then preview the shots, making it much easier on set. You can also share the link and preview any scan on your computer. Alright, so that's one thing. But here comes the most exciting feature. From the app or from your web browser, there's a downloads button on top, which allows you to download the 3D model and import it into any popular 3D software, such as Cinema 4D. So here's where it's really getting interesting. For example, we have this oil barrel and made a scan of it. Download the model and import it into Cinema 4D or something. Then we created a simple animation on the barrel and got the following result. Pretty cool, right? Now, here comes another amazing trick. Have a person stand still in a T pose and scan them in using the app. Then download the model and upload it to a website called Mixamo, which is also an Adobe product. Once uploaded, Mixamo will process your model. Very important is that your model stands in that T pose or it won't work. Once done, you can assign several joints like your head, elbows, hips, knees, etc. Then it's going to process again, and once that is done, you are able to either download your model with a rig, or you can assign one of the pre-built animations and download your model with that. Open it again in Cinema 4D and you got yourself an animated 3D model that you scanned yourself. It is really that easy, you don't even need to know much about Cinema 4D. And it also works with other programs like Blender if you prefer that. So here you go, Janik dancing. We'll be right back. So that's in a nutshell what you can do with Display Land. It's still in heavy development, so at this point they just want to have as many people trying out their app and sharing their feedback. They're also working on a browser-based 3D studio, which looks very promising, so I'm super excited to see where the app is going to in the future. Now make sure to click the first link in the description down below to check out the website of Display Land or to download the app straight away. I'll leave links to everything that I've talked about in the description as well, such as Mixamo. And don't forget to tag us on Instagram if you share something made with Display Land. Really curious to see what you guys are gonna make with it. Thank you so much for watching, thank you Display Land for the support, and as always, stay creative.